your role model. See, in our regular day-to-day life, we see many people. We just come across in our journey of life, many people. We inspire a lot from many people. Okay, suppose if you go and have a coffee at a coffee shop, within a few minutes of time, there might be something that is going to inspire you, either the behavior or the way the person is working, the coffee shop guy. So like this, you come across in a travel journey, in a short-term travel journey, maybe 1 hour or half an hour or maybe 5 hours or 4 hours, you just go ahead and there can be someone who is going to get introduced to you, and you might be getting impressed by them or inspired by them within short span of time. So like this, everyone is going to be inspired by many of the people across the globe, many of the people, those who come across, those whom you are going to meet in your life, in your day-to-day life. Other than this, there should be someone in your life who should be your role model, who might have inspired you a lot in your career, and the way and the path that they have followed, you also wanted to start your journey in the same path. That is what a role model. So being parents as a role model is very common to everyone generally. So if my role model is Abdul Kalam, it doesn't mean that my parents are not my role models. I have been inspired a lot by them. So my life is being given by them. They are also role models. And coming to the goals, short-term goals and long-term goals. Those who do not have a long-term goal at all, just listen to this. Now, you start your journey. You have already started your life journey. Okay, I'm talking about simply a bus journey. Okay, you wanted to travel somewhere where you wanted to start your journey. You get onto the bus. And when conductor comes to you, you say that, okay, he's going to ask you, where do you want to go? Say that, I don't know. So what happens next? He's going to stop the bus immediately. You can just please get down. Okay. You cannot travel in this bus because this is for someone who knows their target actually. If you do not know about what is your target in your journey, you're not allowed to get into the bus. So you're not allowed to travel. You have to sit idle, think about it. Okay. And you set this target and then choose your right bus, get onto that, and then give information that you wanted to reach so and so place. Then we will stop, drop you there. As you don't know your target where to go, what happens? Your life will be nowhere. Your journey will be nowhere. I'm sorry. The same is applicable in your life. You don't have any long-term goal. You have already started your life journey. When you have started your life journey, if you do not have any long-term goal, means you do not know where to go in your life. Exactly, you do not know where to go, where to end. So without knowing end, you cannot even do a journey, a bus journey, simple bus journey. How you take your long-term life to somewhere where you wanted to go and see yourself? So you, one must have a lifetime goal. Having no lifetime goal, as you don't know where to, what is your destination when you are traveling by bus, you have to, you are being kicked out of the journey. Similarly, you will be kicked out of your life by yourself. There is no one else here. It's by yourself. So one must have to set their lifetime goal, what they wanted to do, what they wanted to become. So if you have that goal, then your journey will be good. And here, so when you compare with a bus journey, you are the traveler. There is a driver who knows the path, how to take you, where to drop you when you say, talk about your destination. But for your life journey, you are the own driver. You are the traveler. Okay. You should know where you have to take yourself, where you have to stop, where you have to restart. Okay. When you say this is so-and-so is your lifetime goal, you must clearly know the path to achieve it. To reach your lifetime goal as a destination, you must clearly know the path, how to lead yourself towards your goal. Many of us, without having the goal, you must have to go ahead and set a goal for sure, what you wanted to become. Just think about it for next few days. One must and should have a goal. Otherwise, you see yourself, you see your life journey being nowhere. You have to be, you will be there forever where you are. That's it. So you do not have even, you do not deserve or you do not have rights to dream of something which is called as success. So one must have to set their lifetime goal for sure. Okay, now coming to the people who had some goal, many of us have some goal being set, but we are not working towards it because we do not know the right path. Knowing a right path is most important. That you wanted to travel to so and so location, but you do not know where to travel. You need an assistant. That assistant can be any assistant generally. So using through some assistant, you have to go ahead and reach your goal. So in your journey of traveling, definitely there will be some assistant. If you're going to take a human, if you're going to get onto a bus, driver will be your assistant. If you're going to travel by your own vehicle, maybe some application will be your assistant. Or on your travel of journey, you have to talk to many people. So I wanted to reach to so and so place. What is the path towards it? But in your life goal, no one is going to guide you for this. There will be few people who are really going to guide you, like your parents, your teachers, maybe your friends. But most of the times, you have to guide yourself. You should know your destiny path by your own research. That is most important. You should not depend on anyone else to know that. Okay. Initially, your parents are going to guide you. Later, your teachers are going to guide you. So after you are out of this college, now you are the path maker, you are the driver, and you are the traveler. So you are the assistant, you are the only assistant for yourself where you wanted to go and reach in your life. So now all the roles you must have to play. So your parents will be there with you only up to certain time. Your teachers will be there with you only up to certain time. Your friends also will not be there forever with you, okay, in every moment. So only it's you. You have to set the goals. You have to set the path, design the path towards your goal. And you have to go ahead and guide yourself and assist yourself. And you have to self-motivate yourself always. That is most important. So without having a goal means you are an ideal person in this world. Your life will be nowhere for sure. You set a goal and you are not working towards it. You don't know what path, and you have not started your research towards finding the path to reach your goal. Still, you are the same as someone who do not have goal. So you have to start your research immediately of what is your lifetime goal that you have set, finding a path to reach it. So it has to be done by yourself. You can get some guidance from someone else in the meantime. So this is what you have to set up first. And then you start working on it. So the reason why I have asked your role model is, your role model is someone who has inspired you a lot. So everyone, we will just travel by our own ways always. If you have some role model, let's say, we will choose the path what they have followed throughout their career and life. We will also try to copy the same. Copy the same, not exactly. We are going to copy some, we are being inspired. Instead of saying copy, we are being inspired by the path what they have traveled. We will also make some similar path, might not be exact, some similar path to succeed in our life. So if you do not have something which has already been built, so if you see something which has already been built, you get more better ideas generally. So being creative here, from nothing, being creative is good. Again, if you do not have the creative capabilities, you have to follow someone, you have to look at something which has already been constructed or built, you copy it, meaning that you are being inspired. Copying, not exactly similar, you are being inspired, make little modifications and do design something new. So here you are designing yourself by following someone else's path. Maybe not exactly, but by going through a little bit of changes in the same. So for everyone, it is not possible to follow everyone else exactly. So always when I say your role model, we will always find some good guys only. We will not find someone, let's say, you do not say Kasab is my role model. Because everyone wanted to be good in their life. So ultimately, we wanted to prove this world. We wanted to show this world that we are good and we are successful traveling in a good path. That's why we will always choose our role models are the succeeded people who have done something in this society, who had their stamp left in this country or here on the earth, and they left this one, this place. So if you do not have any role model, let's say, again, like what I have told for not having a goal, same thing will happen. Either you should be most creative, otherwise, if you do not have any role model, you do not know how to travel. So if you wanted to do something, you must be creative. If you are more creative, you can start some, you can just go ahead and create something without copying anything else. So role model is for someone who wanted to grow in their life or in their career, just by copying or inspiring from looking at others' path. This is the easiest way. You are helping yourself with the help of someone else. Not directly, it is indirectly. Your parents will be there up to some extent helping you directly or indirectly maybe. But role models like Abdul Kalam and all will not be with you, but the path will be with you, is already been given to you. So everyone, it is not mandatory, okay? It's good to have someone as your role model and try to learn more about them and their path, what they have followed in their life, what they have chosen in their life to be successful and to prove themselves as best in this country, our world. So you must also have to design something like that for your career that will help you and that will help others also. Others also will be inspired by you and the path what you have designed and left here. So that's how you're going to serve the society. This is also serving a society. And the other thing, this is the reason why I have asked your role models, why I have asked about your career goals. See, you should know the difference between goal and responsibility. Settling successfully in your life settling in your life, like buying a luxury car, buying a home for your family or you, or looking after your parents or your family, serving your society, this is your responsibility. See, in every aspect, we will serve our society. You are going to start a new business. This is for whom? For ourselves. You are going to start a new business for yourself, right? Okay, you have started a new business. You are earning a lot of money. Okay, now you have $1 million. You are serving the society or you are not serving the society? Are you serving the society or you are not serving the society? See, you have started old age home, okay, with the money what you have, collecting money from others as a donations, and you are doing charity. This is serving society. And you have started your own business, you are earning a lot of money, spending it for your family. Obviously, you are buying new car and new home and everything, luxury life you are leading. Now you are serving the society or you are not serving the society? You are serving the society. Again, see, the social service is not only doing some charity kind of things. You yourself do your own job, what you have to do. That is what you have to set as your goal, first of all. What you have to do, and you earn money, you spend for your family and here and there, that's okay. You are paying taxes to government. Through your taxes, what you are paying every day from the income what you are earning, it is being spent for many things, for government schools, for government hospitals, and for army services, for air force services, for ministries, for defense ministry, and many other things. Even for police department. So how they are getting salaries? Every government department. How they are getting salaries? Government is paying them. How government is paying them? Where money is being generated by government? It's not that they simply print every note and then they're going to just distribute it. Okay, so now what is the tax that you are paying that is going to be shared to everyone? Now you are serving society. You are being part of serving society where your money is being spent for a government hospital, for a government school, for every government department. You are a social service worker now. Indirectly, you are a social service worker. So your main responsibility should be first your survival. If your survival is good, everyone, then this country's survival will be good. Country's GDP will be increased. Automatically, this country is going to be number one. If you are idle, you are not working, you do not have any goals, you do not know what your responsibility is, minimum responsibility is, then it doesn't mean that you are only suffering. The entire nation is suffering only because of you. You don't have job doesn't mean you are only suffering. As you don't have job, definitely this country is suffering. This is how you have to think. So you want to get a job, not only for yourself. You wanted to settle in your life, in your career, you wanted to get a job. It's not only for yourself, it's also for your nation. It's also for the society. See, your parents will be happy when you are a good person. Good person in the sense where you have social response, you have responsibility towards yourself, first of all. This is the first thing. You have responsibility towards your family. You have responsibility towards your society. You have responsibility towards your nation. Okay, now come from the order from top to bottom. The bottom three, responsibility, your responsibility to yourself, your responsibility to family, your responsibility towards society, and then country. Those who have responsibility, those who feel responsible about their nation, feel the remaining three automatically. You are responsible citizen in this country. You feel like in every action that you do, you are responsible towards your nation. That means automatically you are responsible towards society. You are being responsible towards your family, as well as you are being responsible yourself. So the first thing what we should have, everyone should have, your responsibility towards your nation. You wanted to be responsible, looking after your family members, looking after your parents. This is okay. If you say, I wanted to take care of responsibility of my nation, that means you have said everything else. You have said you have showed your responsibility towards society, you have showed your responsibility towards your family and yourself as well. So your nation is first in your responsibilities. And your goal is something where you wanted to achieve something and wanted to be successful. That is what you have to set. So when you say, when I ask you what is your goal, so going next time onwards, instead of saying, I wanted to look after my family, if you say, I wanted to take care of my nation by serving the nation, then you have said everything else. So this is where you have to aim. This is how your thinking should be changed. So something, if you are working, that should be for your nation first. And then your society automatically, your family, and it will be done for yourself for sure. Keeping this in mind, you have to be a responsible citizen. Otherwise, you find yourself definitely being nowhere, for sure. So it always, your perception and your views and your thinking, that makes yourself in this society. So what are you, if I'm going to ask you, what are you will be defined by your views, by your perception, the way how you think, the way how you act on the things. Overall, it is called as your attitude and your behavior. So this is what makes a man. See, when I ask you this, I might have asked many times before,